Essence of Bhagavad Gita, Chapter 5, Karma Sannyasa Yoga. In the fifth chapter, Krishna summarizes the teachings from the first three chapters. It can be broadly broken down into four sections. Description of two different lifestyles, two types of spiritual disciplines, the benefits of following these disciplines, and the introduction of meditation as preparation for the next chapter. The two different lifestyles discussed are the Grihastha Ashrama, the lifestyle of a householder, and Sannyasa Ashrama, the lifestyle of a renunciate. The householder lives an active life, possesses everything, and partakes in all karma. The sannyasi does not possess anything. He is not part of society and lives a secluded life. Arjuna is confused about which ashrama is better for him, and Krishna offers his advice. The Lord said, "Both sannyasa and karma yoga are conducive to liberation. However, among these two, karma yoga is better than sannyasa." Krishna says both ashramas are good for sadhana, but for a majority of people, grihastha ashrama is better. Why so? The required sadhanas for any seeker are karma yoga and jnana yoga. In grihastha ashrama, one can efficiently follow karma yoga, but may have difficulty spending time on jnana yoga. In sannyasa ashrama, opportunity for karma yoga is greatly reduced, but there is plenty of time for jnana yoga. Krishna says there is a choice of ashrama, but there is no choice in sadhana. Everyone must go through karma yoga and jnana yoga. Krishna transitions to the next sadhana, which is jnana yoga, in verses 13 to 21. Jnana yoga can be broken into three stages. Shravanam, consistent and systematic study of the scriptures for a length of time under the guidance of a competent guru. Mananam, internalization or conviction, re-examining the lessons until all doubts are removed. Nidityasanam, assimilation of the knowledge by changing my perspective. Even when engaged in action, the person who realizes he is the Atma is free from actions and karma. Actions will continue at the physical and mental level, but I am detached from my body-mind complex, so I realize that I do not act, my body-mind complex does. It is not external renunciation, but inner detachment. I realize I am the Atma and so is everyone else. In verses 22 to 26, Krishna discusses the benefits of following karma yoga and jnana yoga. In verses 27 to 29, Krishna introduces the topic of meditation, which he wants to elaborate on in the sixth chapter. Om Tat Sat.